हेलो स्टूडेंट, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न कंस्ट्रक्शन प्रैक्टिस लैब। इन कंस्ट्रक्शन प्रैक्टिस लैब एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 11, फैब्रिकेशन ऑफ टिम्बर और स्टील फॉर्मर फॉर अ मोनोलिथिकली कास्टेड बीम एंड स्लैब। सो द फॉर्मर इज अ टेम्पररी स्ट्रक्चर इन विच द रेनफोर्समेंट बार इज प्लेसड एंड वेट कॉन्क्रीट इज प्योर्ड एंड कॉम्पैक्टेड to harden till it reaches required strength. The basic requirement of a formwork is to give the concrete the necessary shape and support while it is sitting and hardening. Timber is the most commonly used material in the fabrication of a formwork. It can be easily be put into required shape and can easily be fixed and dismantled. Mostly soft wood will be used. Steel formwork may be used as an alternative timber and it particularly suitable where standard size units are possible. Steel shuttering in initially more expensive. Okay. So requirement of a good formwork is the strong enough to withstand the dead and live load. Capable of retaining its shape by being efficiently propped and brassed horizontally and vertically. Okay. Third, joints should prevent leakage of a cement grout. Should be capable being removed in various parts without damaging the concrete. Material used be suitable for reuse. Should be set accurately to the desired line as lightweight as possible. Okay. Eighth one, material should not warp or destroy or expose to the elements. Should rest on a firm base. Okay. So formwork for a beam, panel shuttering, girder, props. This is a ladder and this is a panel end support. This is a props, stringer, brassing. Okay. So let's move on. So procedure. The procedure of a formwork for a beam is for the drawing. Take the size of various components of a formwork. Prepare the components like shuttering, yokes, posts, cleats to the exact measurement with the help of saw. The side form of the beam consists of 3 cm thick shuttering. The bottom sheathing of the beam from maybe 5 to 7 cm thick. The ends of the battens are supported on the ledger which is fixed to the cleat. Throughout out the length. Okay. So the formwork in contact with concrete is cleaned and thoroughly wetted or treated with approved oil before placing of a concrete. The horizontal surface are laid level by checking with spirit level in circumstance and where ordinary cement is used, formwork may be stripped after expiry of the following periods. So first, vertical sides of the beam is 1 to 2 days. Second, beam soffits, props left under 7 days. Okay. Third one, removal of a props up to 6 meter. So 6 meter to 14 days. Okay. Here it is formwork for a slab. See the diagram. Here it is the, this is slab. Okay. This is considering beam. So see the, this is a floating wedges, head tree, batten, joist, vertically props. Okay. Then next, this is a cleat, slab sitting, settings. Okay. So procedure, the formwork in concrete, the formwork in contact with concrete is cleaned and thoroughly wetted or treated with approved oil before placing of a concrete. The horizontal surface are laid level by checking with spirit level. In normal and ordinary cement is used. Formwork may be stripped after expiry of the following period. So first, vertical sides of the beams 1 to 2 days, slabs props left under 3 days, removal of props up to 4.5 meter is 7 days and above 4.5 meter is 14 days. Okay. So let's move on the calculation of beam. So given size of beam is 300 mm by 450 mm and length of beam is 3 into 4 meter. So first one is props. What is props? Props provide the ideal and the most economic method of a support for all kinds of formwork, slabs, beams, walls and columns. Props are used in all type of construction works to withstand vertical loads or axe head wall, brass, wherever adjustable loads bearings members are required. Props second name is jack, or in Marathi bamboo is called. Okay. So standard spacing props is 450 mm center to center. Number of props we are going to calculate. The length of beam divided by spacing of props plus 1 is the formula of number of props. So we have got the 8 numbers of props. Second, planks. So bottom planks and side planks are calculated. So bottom plank is our 2 numbers and side plank is 4 numbers. Okay. So area of beam we are going to calculate. So area of a bottom plank plus area of side plank is the formula of area of beam. So our area of beam is 3.6 meter square. Third one, nails. We are going to calculate nails. So area 9 meter square nails required is 1 kg. So we are got the area of beam is 3.6 meter square. So we are going to calculate the 3.6 meter square nails required. So our 3.6 divided by, we are going to calculate 9, so we are get 0.4 kgs of a nails. Okay. So shearing battens or supporting battens. So what is shearing battens and supporting battens? A batten is generally a strip of timber. Okay. So I think you are confusing the this plank. What is plank? Okay, a plank is a timber that is flat, elongated and rectangular with parallel faces that are higher and longer than wide. So in Marathi called plank is fadi. Okay. So shearing battens of a formula is length of beam divided by spacing of batten plus 1. So spacing of batten is 150 mm center to center. So shearing battens we are got the 7 numbers. Okay. This is a tabular column for a beam. So number of particular quantity total. So props, number of quantity is 8 numbers, planks, bottom planks is 2, side planks is 4, and nails 0.4 kg, supporting battens 7 numbers, okay. So let's move on the calculation of slab. So size of slab is our 3 into 4 meter. So 12 meters square. Area plank is 1.5 into 2. So 3 meters square is our area of plank. So planks is number of planks we are going to calculate is 4 numbers. So area divided by size of slab divided by area of planks. So number of planks is 4 numbers. Props calculation with standard spacing is 450 mm center to center. Props are we are going to calculate in x direction and y direction. So x direction props is 8 numbers and y direction props is 10 numbers. The total number of props is 18 numbers. Okay. So we are going to calculate nails. Area 9 meter square nails required 1 kg. Then 12 meter square required nails we are going to calculate is 1.33 kg. Okay. So battens. Battens we are going to calculate x direction and y direction. The battens formula is length of slab divided by spacing of battens plus 1. So we are getting the x direction battens is 7 numbers and y direction battens is 9 numbers. So total number of battens is 7 plus 9, so 16 numbers. So tabular column for a slab is SL number, particular quantity, total. So planks is we are getting 4 numbers and props 18 numbers. Nails 1.33 kgs, supporting battens 16 numbers, okay. So thank you student, hope you like this video and enjoy this session. Thank you.